Welcome back, Tom Sherry. Always good for a recommendation. And tis the season for the Nutcracker.
Right, and we only have a certain window that you get to watch this. We're talking about the Nutcracker Ballet that is happening downtown Spokane right now at the Fox Theater going through Sunday. You can get more information by dialing that number there on your screen, 624-1200. Again, the Nutcracker Ballet with the fabulous Spokane Symphony through Sunday. They've got evening and matinee performances over the weekend, so check it out. It's a family tradition. Here we go with headlines. Tracking decreasing rain and snow tonight. Isolated weekend snow showers possible. And then we'll look for mostly dry and cold weather next week. When you take a look at the latest radar, you can see most of the wet weather has now moved into northern Idaho and then eventually into western Montana. Most of Washington State now drying out. But we did get those big fat snowflakes. But I told you yesterday that I didn't think you were going to have to really do a lot of shoveling, that most of them would melt or not stick when they actually fell. We have dropped temperatures down to 33 degrees. Boy, you head a little farther west. Look at the big change there. 44 right now in Ritzville and 42 in Moses Lake. Coeur d'Alene checks in at 34 degrees. Future tracker, let's run this thing. 3:30 tomorrow morning. Snow begins to develop in these areas right here. Right now, the modeling has them to the west of Spokane. That's at 3:30 in the morning. Then we continue to 9:30 in the morning. The computer model does not have them reaching Spokane, but our viewers out in areas of central Washington still going to get some of those scattered snow showers. And then it really dries out by the evening hours. There's 6:30. Let's run it through Sunday, and you're going to see snow showers in central Idaho, northern Idaho, but it doesn't look like we'll see any activity in central or north central Washington. Sunday up through 4 o'clock, you get a few pop-up snow showers around the area. So I'm not going to rule some out in the Spokane area, but it looks like most of them will be to the east and to the north of us. Temperature-wise, we're looking for daytime highs in the 30s. So finally a return to more average daytime high temperatures. Instead of all the 40s that we've seen, we'll see highs tomorrow only in the 30s. And I'm expecting the overnight low to drop down to 33, maybe 32. Lots of fog overnight. We could see some of that freezing to the roadway, so watch out for black ice. Obviously down to 32 in Newport and up in Sandpoint. Colville getting cold overnight, down to 31, so could see some slick roads up there. Then a daytime high of 39 degrees. Here's a look at your 7-day outlook. Again, we've got 38 tomorrow, 36 on Sunday. Cold next week. May drop down into the teens early Thursday and Friday morning. We're back with more news after the break.